Now, when the Democrats attack you and attack the, what I know you've said, and I would certainly concur, is the most conservative Senate in the history of the legislature.
Without question.
When the
most successful, I think.
When Democrats attack, Joaquin Castro tweeted the other day, worst legislative session in history, that's kind of like a no surprise moment that Democrats
are
attacking.
That means we really have
From your perspective, that's like, bring it. I want more of that, right? But I'm looking at the people who I would say are conservatives, people who I would assume line up with you. The chair of your grassroots advisory council, Joanne Fleming, graded the session. She gave the Senate a C, she gave the House an F,
she gave the overall legislature a D.
Yeah,
she grades on the curve. So we really had an A and the House had a C.
Is that how you're looking at it, right? Yeah, nice try.
Look, you know, the truth, Evan, is there are going to be people in the grassroots or people in the business community. Some people want 100%. Anything less than 100% is not an A. Speaking of A's, by the way, one of my education priorities was to grade our schools A through F.
And you got it.
I think it's the most powerful tool that we could possibly have. Last session, as education chair, I passed a bill to make our districts A through F. And this is another result of the 21 vote rule.
Right.
A through F. And so that bill passed. I can't please 100% of the people 100% of the time, but do I walk out of there saying, we checked off the boxes of everything we campaigned on? 21 out of 25.
But I want to understand, I want to press you a little bit on this. I want to understand what it is exactly that they find so wanting. So I mentioned Joanne Fleming.
Yeah.
Jonathan Stickland, who became an emblem of the House's dissatisfaction with the ideological purity of the legislature this session, C+. Adam Kahneman, right here, who is associated with some of the grassroots conservatives who are loudest in pushing an agenda during the session. You know, they have a very particular point of view about a number of issues. He yesterday blogged about the session and gave out a mix of C's, D's, and mostly F's. The Students for Concealed Carry talked about a gutted bill. You all are hiding behind a gutted bill, the bill you passed. Steve Hotze, you're a longtime supporter, called you out on not sufficiently putting forth same-sex marriage legislation. This is a group of people who I would assume, most people would assume, would be with you. They found what you all did and what you did specifically wanting. I want to understand what happened here, why that is.
I have no idea why they have that view. When you have a session that passes the most conservative budget you could pass, when you increase border security, which is the number one issue, almost 2.5 times, when you cut taxes, we haven't even mentioned the franchise tax, we cut by 25%. Significant cut. I mean, there are some people would say, well, you failed because you didn't get rid of it all in 1 year. Well, then that's just their view. Look, I have to do what I believe we can do and achieve as much as we can. And in those areas, we did. In terms of the marriage issue, we passed the Pastor Protection Bill, which was the key bill I know that a number of people wanted passed, very important.
Right.
4105, we were hoping was coming from the House. It didn't. It got tied up in calendars, which was the quote, Hotze bill. But we, at least in the Senate, and we did amend it to a bill that was blocked on the floor, so that's all you can do. You just can't put language on any bill you want. It has to be germane, despite some emails that go around. But we did have a great debate on the floor on traditional marriage and same-sex marriage.
Ultimately got the Hancock resolution, but did not
get all 20 Republicans that signed it.
But in the end, the resolution doesn't change anything.
No, but let me tell you what, statute doesn't change it. You can't write a bill that trumps our Constitution. Our Constitution says marriage is between a man and a woman, period. I can't write a bill that says, oh, by the way, we want to remind you, Eric. So, and I respect those who agree to disagree. The votes weren't there to move some of those bills.
So if the U.S. Supreme Court comes back and says same-sex marriage is legal, will you write a bill to trump that Constitution?
Depending on what the Supreme Court decides, that's the time we will have to make a decision of, depending on their decision, how we respond to that. We responded, we thought, number one, by protecting pastors. We did not want pastors forced to perform a wedding, a same-sex wedding, against their religious beliefs. And we passed that bill, and that will be another fight, depending on what the Supreme Court
does. You understand, some of the people who don't want to see marriage equality or same-sex marriage legal in the state of Texas have actually called for a special session.
Sure.
If the Supreme Court comes back and legalizes same-sex marriage, they want you all to come back and do what you were not able or not willing to do during this last session, and that is pass legislation that would somehow countermand what's happening at the federal level.
Well,
what do you think about that?
The governor makes those decisions, not the lieutenant governor.
Right, but lieutenant governors in the past, including one you defeated last year, have been perfectly willing to say, I think the governor should call a special session on blank. You are not shy about offering your opinion on stuff.
I have been very careful to understand that the governor is the governor, the lieutenant governor is the lieutenant governor, and the speaker is the speaker.
Right.
And I perform best when I focus on my work.
You're only responsible for your piece.